For what purpose does the gentleman from New York seek recognition?
Mr. Chairman, I have an amendment at the desk made in order under the rule numbered 1 of Part A of House Report 112-34.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 1, printed in Part A of House Report number 112-34, offered by Mr. Hanna of New York.
Pursuant to House Resolution 170, the gentleman from New York, Mr. Hanna, and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from New York, Mr. Hanna.
Thank you. This amendment would add a findings section detailing the flaws of the Home Affordability Modification Program, or HAMP. It would also state that terminating HAMP would result in significant savings for the American taxpayer. I filed this amendment during Sunshine Week, which highlights the importance of open government. In keeping with the spirit of transparency, this amendment would include within the bill the specific reasons why we should end the failed HAMP program. The HAMP program was designed to assist between 3 and 4 million homeowners. However, as of February, only 607,000 active permanent mortgages modifications were made under HAMP, while $30 billion was obligated by the Treasury to HAMP. Only $1.04 billion has been disbursed. Furthermore, the Special Inspector General for TARP reported that HAMP offers many homeowners little more than false hope and, in certain cases, causes more harm than good. The program does not fulfill its intended purpose of helping American homeowners. It delays rather than prevents foreclosure. This program was flawed from the beginning. According to the Wall Street Journal, the number of applications canceled so far exceeds those approved, and the number of applications continues to slow. I agree with the Journal's assessment, which also pointed out that keeping people in homes they cannot afford is bad policy. Incentivizing mortgage services to do just that exacerbates our housing crisis. Moreover, the private sector is better equipped to deal with the problem, and they have modified nearly double the number of loans themselves without government involvement. My amendment concludes that ending this ineffective program would save taxpayers $1.4 billion, and that's according to the Congressional Budget Office. This is one step towards restoring fiscal discipline to our federal government. Too often, our constituents receive biased or incomplete information on the issues we are discussing in Congress, thus making it difficult for them to make informed assessments of our work. Including additional facts on the intended consequences of legislation is beneficial to the public. That is why I urge support for the Hanna Amendment in the underlying bill. I yield back the balance of my time.